This is Apollo Control. We're getting quite a bit of noise on the air-to-ground circuit at this time as the spacecraft rotates from one Omni antenna around to the next, and we momentarily lose lock-on. At this time, Apollo 11 is 183,544 nautical miles from Earth. The velocity holding fairly constant now at about 3,042 feet per second. It's been moving down toward 3,000 feet per second and seems to be leveling off somewhat. This is Apollo Control. We're going to take the air-to-ground circuit down temporarily until a stronger antenna lock is a... Here's a call to the crew. We'll stand by for that. This is Apollo Control. We will take the air-to-ground circuit down at this time until we have reestablished sufficient signal strength to eliminate the noise on the circuit. Thank you. This is Apollo Control at 60 hours, 10 minutes. We've reestablished good antenna lock on at this time, and we'll continue to monitor for any conversation from the spacecraft. The crew is presently reestablishing the passive thermal control rotation rate of 3 revolutions per hour. Following that, we expect they will begin their rest period. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 183,821 nautical miles from Earth, and the velocity 3,037 feet per second.
Hello, Apollo 11. Hello, Apollo 11. Over. Roger. Reading about one by. Looks like we picked a super attitude here for PTC stabilization. We're reading you in a backup voice now, over.
Can we read you loud? Clear.
Roger. I think we've got about the best configuration. We have been doing it all from the ground here, 11. We'll just keep it as it is, over. Apollo 11, Houston, would you select Command Reset and Omni Alpha, over.
Houston 11 on Omni Alpha.
Roger, we read you about 3 by now, over.
Roger.
Apollo 11, Houston, we is stable. You can start the PTC, over.
Apollo 11, Roger.
Houston, Apollo 11, on checklist page S9-7. I've completed step 8, and I'd like to know what you think is ideal timing between step 8 and step 9 and step 10 on that page, over.
Roger, stand by. Apollo 11, Houston, we don't see any time constraints. We'd like you to go ahead and set up the wide dead band, then go through step 10 and 11, over.
Okay, will do. I don't see any constraints either, Charlie. I just was checking to make sure, because last time I went from 8 to 9 to 10 to 11 a little bit more swiftly than I've been doing in the past.
Roger.
Step 11 complete.
Roger, we copy. Apollo 11, Houston, would you please select Omni Bravo, over.
Roger, Bravo. Houston, Apollo 11, how do you read on Bravo?
Roger, reading you 5-I.
Same here.
Apollo 11, Houston, it looks like we got a good PTC going. It's good night from the white team, over.
Okay, see you tomorrow. Thank you for everything.
This is Apollo Control at 60 hours, 37 minutes. We said goodbye or good night to the crew about 10 minutes ago. We expect that they will be settling down for their rest period shortly. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 184,600 nautical miles from Earth. The spacecraft velocity is presently 3,023 feet per second. Now, we understand there's been some interest in a comment made by Neil Armstrong during the television transmission about the EVA floodlight. Armstrong's remark was that the mast, which the light is mounted on, appeared charred. He reported that the light works, but had apparently the mast that supported it had apparently been damaged during the launch phase. This light would be used in the event of a contingency EVA. It would have no function in a normal mission, such as we're presently flying. And in the event that an extravehicular activity was necessary for transfer of the crew from the LEM to the command and service module, the light would be an aid in providing exterior lighting of the handrails, but would repeat that it would have no function in a normal mission. And the charring, which Armstrong reported, is not considered significant at this time. We don't expect to have any further conversation with the crew. We will continue to record any remarks that we get and play those back. The passive thermal control mode, which was reestablished, appears to be functioning well at this time, and all spacecraft systems are functioning normally. At 100, or rather at 60 hours, 39 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston. This is Apollo Control at 60 hours, 47 minutes. We just got a call from the spacecraft requesting that we give them the position of the S-4B in respect to the spacecraft. And we're currently coming up with that bit of information, so we'll stand by.
Apollo 11, Houston, the S-4B is about 6,000 nautical miles from you now, over.
Okay, thank you.
Houston, Apollo 11, how's the PTC looking?
Stand by. Eleven, Houston, the PTC looks great to us, over.
Okay, do you have any idea what happened to the previous one?
We have absolutely no idea, over.
Okay. Did it look like it was all right and then just all of a sudden start diverging?
That's negative. If you look at the plot, which we'll say for you, and let you see it post-flight, it started off immediately on the first rev and just spiraled out to about 20 degrees in pitch, and then it seemed to be setting up a spiral around an offset pitch point of about 20 degrees off from 90 degrees, but we didn't want to take a chance that it would become stable at that point. We thought it might diverge, so we called you and started over again, over.
Okay, thank you. Okay, no complaints. I was just curious as to what had happened.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 61 hours, 39 minutes. We've had no further conversation with the crew since our last report. Flight surgeon says there is no indication at this time that they have begun to sleep, but we expect they'll be getting to sleep here shortly. Coming up in less than 10 seconds now, we'll be crossing into the sphere of influence of the moon. A computational changeover will be made here in Mission Control. At this point, as the moon's gravitational force becomes the dominant effect on the spacecraft trajectory, and our displays will shift from Earth reference to moon reference. At that point, which occurred a few seconds ago, the spacecraft was at a distance of 186,437 nautical miles from Earth and 33,822 nautical miles from the Moon. The velocity with respect to the Earth was 2,990 feet per second, and with respect to the Moon, about 3,272 feet per second. The passive thermal control mode that was set up for the second time by the crew appears to be holding well at this point, and all spacecraft systems are functioning normally. The mission going very smoothly. At 61 hours, 41 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 62 hours, 29 minutes. The flight surgeon reports that the crew appears to have been asleep now for about the past 30 minutes. The spacecraft appears also to be holding its passive thermal control attitude very well. And at this time, Apollo 11 is about 32,000 miles from the moon, traveling at a speed of 3,782 feet per second. In the past 50 minutes or so, we've seen that velocity increase about 10 feet per second, going from 3772 feet per second to the present 3782 as the spacecraft continues to accelerate toward the moon. The change of shift briefing following this shift will occur at about 11:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Flight Director Glenn Lunny and his team of flight controllers are coming on now, being debriefed by the Eugene Kranz team, and that shift change will be occurring shortly here. The new capsule communicator will be astronaut Ron Evans. At 62 hours, 30 minutes, this is Apollo Control.